Back here in Anaheim, Honda Center, the set of tonight's preseason action. These two met in Ontario Saturday. The Kings won 3-2, and the matchup in goal for tonight, veteran Darcy Kuemper, reacquired in the offseason by the Kings. He will go last year with Washington, and he opposes Oscar Dansk. In his career in the NHL, only six games, a record of 4-1-0. The backup to Darcy Kuemper will be David Rittich. Cal Klang will back up Oscar Dansk. Kings playing their fourth preseason game. As we get a look at Darcy Kuemper, had a good season with the Kings. And, of course, a couple of seasons ago, a real good season with Colorado as he helped backstop the Avalanche to a Stanley Cup championship. Philip Deneau will start at center with Tanner Janot and Akil Thomas. Defensively, Spence with Mikey Anderson. Again, no Drew Doughty. Listed month to month. Drew fractured his ankle last Wednesday in Vegas. Ducks get it in the attacking zone. Strome's pass broken up. Kings get it out to center. Lifted in by Thomas. Tanner Janot acquired in the offseason from Tampa and on the forecheck. Janot is there. Ducks have possession. Janot bothering Tristan Luneau, young defenseman. Kings back off, and Luneau will hand the puck off. Kings get the Byfield line out. Byfield, Fiala, and another newcomer, Warren Fogle. Ducks work it to the left wing and a shot block. Lakanainen with it now in front. It comes, and oh, sparkling save off Colangelo by Darcy Kuemper.
That was the first step across by Kuemper that allowed him to make the save. He came across so quick that he was actually able to set himself.
Now in front, it deflects, and Nestorenko a whack at it, but I think it went off a defender's stick. Now the Ducks with more pressure and a chance from the left wing. Zegras and a save in tight by Kuemper. So the last couple of shifts, the Ducks have created some good looks. And finally, the other way is Alex Turcotte, but he's tied up at the attacking blue line, and Zegras, and the Ducks will get it back into the Kings' end.
So many times the game of hockey is about pressure, and right now the Ducks, I know it's really early in this game, only a couple of shifts, their first man pressure right there.
Jack Studnicka, number 53 for the Kings, signed as a free agent, has some NHL experience, feeds it out to the blue line. One-timer from the right side, Movarara, who was set up by his partner, Englund. Movarara again, a shot block, didn't get through, picked up, shot just wide by Studnicka, who's out there with Samuel Fagimo, and those two, Studnicka and Fagimo, Jim, had some good looks against Anaheim in the game Saturday.
Yeah, they certainly did. Against Studnicka, probably stood out to us more than most, just from the standpoint of doing different things, a variety of things to help.
He's battling to win a job up front. And there's a shot from the left wing, sails wide. Spence up high, a drive through traffic block. Don't think it got through to Dansk. Spence again set up. Across for Anderson. Shot it wide, hoping for a carom. Didn't get the carom he wanted, and Anaheim will take over.
Any size out there for the Kings right now, Nick? Up front, you have Lee at 6'6". You have Elenius at 6'5". And then you have Parker Jones at 6'7". Yeah. All on the same line.
We were talking before the game. I don't think I can ever remember a line as big as those three. Preseason, regular season, whatever, as the puck goes out of play. So the Ducks with some looks early on.
Yeah, they certainly did. Kuemper was forced into a save that he had to come all the way across, and it's one of those situations where peel up. Yeah, he made a great push. He got the foot on the post, pushed across. Look at that. He is there. A lot of times in that type of situation, you're scrambling. With Kuemper, he was there with a glove over top of the pad to have a double effect right there, just in case goes over the pad, make a save with a glove.
Yeah, and that glove was wide open, Jim, when he came across, which takes away just a little bit more space and kind of plays on the mind of the shooter when you take a look up and all of a sudden you see leather.
Scoreless here early on. First period at Honda Center. Deneau's line back out with Thomas. And Jano, if all goes according to plan, we'll see Trevor Moore on this line with Dano and Jano when the regular season starts a week from Thursday in Buffalo. First seven to start the regular season on the road for the Kings. Ducks problems with the puck in their own zone, held in by Thomas, try to get it in deep to Janot. Janot to Thomas is checked from behind. Going to be a penalty. Cross-checking in the Kings on the power play.
Well, both teams will want to work on the special team, so the Kings will get a chance to work on the man advantage. The Ducks will get a chance to work on the man down. Thomas inserted into that situation here because in the morning we thought it was Trevor Moore, but
26.
We'll
minor
see
penalty,
the extended arms from behind. You can see there it's a push more than anything because there was really no contact with a stick. So cross-check would not be, that's the official call. That's what the referee saw, but it's still dangerous in that area. We saw a similar penalty called on Saturday where it's not necessarily about the force. It's about knocking a guy off balance when you're close to the boards. You do that, you go to the box.
Kings last year on the power play, 12th at 23%. And of course, a lot of the players that will be on the first unit come regular season are not in the lineup tonight. Most notably, Kopitar and Kempe. Now here's a turnover and a breakaway. Shorthanded, Vetrano stopped by Kemper. So right off the draw, Vetrano races out of the Duck zone, but is foiled by Darcy Kemper.
Yeah, Jordan Spence got caught in no man's land right there. Of course, you win a draw in the offensive zone on the power play. You want to keep it alive. He took the chance. He didn't get the puck. He didn't get the man, and all of a sudden, breakaway the other way.
Kings with the man advantage. Jordan Spence, a right shot defenseman, was on that second power play unit last year quite a bit. So Jim Hiller, the new coach, will take a look at Spence and young Grant Clark here in the preseason and see if they're capable of being on either the first or second power play unit in the absence of Drew Doughty.
On the first minute, there's penalty kill for Anaheim. They've been very aggressive regardless where the puck is in the defensive zone or at their own line. They're throwing two guys, forcing the Kings to make a perfect play.
Early on, out chancing the Kings are the Ducks. 3-1, a hit at center ice. The fans get a charge out of that here at Honda Center. And now we're going to get a penalty on the goalie.
Yep. Interference will be the call. The back ref made the call. The action ref, who was standing right there, elected not to. There's a lot of times where the back ref has a better view
of things. Los Angeles goaltender, number 35, 2 minutes interference.
Not necessarily sure this was the case here, but the Ducks tried to keep the pressure going. And Darcy felt that he had to do something here to help out. He stands in the way, but you can see there, much like in basketball, that was a stationary pick. He didn't go out of his way. He didn't change his position, he being Kemper. So he felt there should not have been. Have to be fair here to Jordan Spence. Here's the play that led to the breakaway. I think Jordan was put in a tough situation there. I mentioned he kind of took a gamble. He did not. His teammates got himself the puck there where a situation where, man, he really didn't have many options with it. That's why the breakaway developed.
So some 4-on-4 hockey for 37 seconds. Scoreless first period. Kings and the Ducks tonight. Turcotte and Fogel are the forwards up front. Englund back with Movarara. Loose puck to Fogel, base of the left circle. Out up top. Englund winds, shoots, and he missed the net. Good look there for Andreas Englund. Now Fogel to the right circle for Turcotte. Turning, moving up high. Took a wrist shot. Save. Cleared away by the defense. Boy, the Kings, I think everybody thought it was going to be covered by Dance, but clearly you could see it even from way up top here at Honda Center that it was fair game.
And the shot there by Turcotte wasn't overly hard, and I think when it went into the padding of the goaltender, he really couldn't get a feel for it. And Dance thought he had it, but it was well in behind him.
Now the Ducks have an abbreviated power play in a scoreless first period. Frank Vetrano, who had that shorthanded bid, is out there. He had 13 power play goals last year to lead Anaheim, but the Kings get a clear.
I think on that play by Turcotte, if he would have shot it harder, I think it's probably easier for the goaltender to at least feel the puck and know where it is.
Olin Zellwiger, talented young defenseman, a lot of offensive skills. Carried it in deep, fed it up the wall, and now a board battle. Puck deflects. Studnicka and Zegras come together. Spence is there. Puck worked free. Held in Anaheim. Vetrano down low. One-timer fanned on by Zegras. Power play, Anaheim, another 10 seconds, and the Kings will get a clear.
You saw just a little bit more aggression right there on the penalty kill, both the forwards and the defensemen. I know Jarrett Stoll went over that in the pregame show. It's going to be four men working. The alignment's going to be a little bit different this year, but also the mindset.
No shots on goal for Anaheim on their short power play. Just over a minute. Scoreless first period. And the Kings take over. Hellenius, a lead pass broken up by Leeson. Works it off the right wing boards into Kings ice, where it's cleared by Kyle Burrows. Burrows, a right shot acquired in the offseason from San Jose. And as we mentioned in the open, Burrows, Spence, and Grant Clark are the only three defensemen left in camp that are right shots. And we talked about this, Jim, the other night. It wasn't that long ago the Kings had too many right shot defensemen. Turnover at center ice. Puck is fed in. And good hit by Englund as he lined up Jan Misak at the Kings line.
I think in both the games between the Kings and the Ducks, we've seen young players not necessarily aware of where the pressure's coming from, and they get drilled.
Meyer from 50 feet. Glove down by Kemper. And we'll take a timeout. Alex Turcotte, a look a few moments ago for the Kings. Still scoreless.
Newell Brown on the left, new assistant coach Jim Hiller in the middle, DJ Smith. Hyundai Keys. Well, we talked about the size, not only the big young guys, but can the Kings play bigger as a team and transition? Stop it up in the neutral zone, go the other way. Darryl, what are you watching for?
I'm looking for the Kings to play with pace and execution. Get the puck up the ice as quickly as you can, move it clean, execute in the offensive end.
Early on, Ducks out shooting, out chancing the Kings.
Oh, yeah.
Shots are 6-3, and they've had the best looks.
The best chance for the Kings was the shot there by Turcotte, but really it was a stoppable situation.
Fogel up the ice into the zone. His pass to his left is blocked. Vetrano knocks it off the glass, gets it down, chased down by Zegras to the left circle King zone, and it knocked away from him by Mikey Anderson. Anderson ahead to center, tipped to Fiala on left wing. Fiala drops it off to Spence. Spence to the trailer, shot Anderson blocked. Anderson letting it go from just inside the blue line. And now Vetrano, a 37-goal scorer last year, led Anaheim in that category, will get it in deep. And a scoreless first period. Kings have the Byfield line out. Along with Fiala. And Fogel. Now they go for a change. Leeson up the right wing. Gains the line. Gets rubbed out by Gavrikov. Now the two do battle in the corner. To the left of Darcy Kemper. Akil Thomas away with it for Burrows. And back ahead to center. Thomas off his stick. In transition, Anaheim, Nestorenko to Leeson, right circle, fanned on an opportunity. Puck picked up by the Kings and cleared off a skate, but not out. Second opportunity as the Ducks back off. And here's Burrows to center ice for L.A. Burrows on a shoot-in. The veteran Deneau begins his fourth season in L.A. Leaves it behind the net, and they work it right side, and a chance to flex out of play.
Well, Jim Hiller, we saw him behind the bench again. I've used the word transition in the keys for tonight, and that's a couple of different things. That is the system transition, but for Jim Hiller also, I think he has a transition as far as personnel. The Kings trying to get a little bit more nasty, a little bit more sandpaper. So you have transition new players coming in. You have a player like Quentin Byfield, who's transitioning to the center position and probably getting more ice time. And then again, with the injury of Drew Doughty, the transition that's happening. So transition might be the word of the month, at least, for the LA Kings.
Yeah, of course, with the Byfield, who's only 22, moving in the middle, the coaches will monitor things like his defensive zone coverage and his faceoffs as up the ice goes Strome, shot off a stick and out of play.
We talked with Hiller the other day about that, Nick, about Byfield, and Jim was, he said, Quentin's ready.
But he also said, you know, it's one of those situations, right? You have to take it. It's never going to be given to you. You have to prove it. But everything we've seen so far from Quinton Byfield, Darryl touched on it in the pregame show where he's a little bit bigger, he's a little bit stronger, get a little bit more experience, along with the quickness and skill.
Kopitar, Deneau, and Byfield look to be 1, 2, and 3 down the middle to start the regular season, which will be a week from Thursday in Buffalo with the Sabres. Scoreless here in the first period. Studnicka out with Turcotte and Fagimo as the Ducks get it in behind the Kings net. Darcy Kuemper around the wall and out to center ice. Zellweger hands it off to Lundestrom, former first-round pick. Boy, the Ducks have a lot of first-round picks on their training camp roster. All Anaheim first-round picks. Now Hellenius a chance off a stick. Dumoulin's and out of play. Midway through the first in Anaheim, Andreas Englund has been a physical presence tonight.
Welcome back to Kings preseason hockey. Jordan Spence is playing up with Mikey Anderson in tonight's game at the Honda Center. And I talked to Jordan the other day about mentally what was it like when Drew Doughty went down in the game against Vegas this preseason. He says he's been so consistent with this team on and off the ice. So mentally, seeing him go down, we were kind of down. He's such a big part of our team, a leader on the ice. And guys, this really stuck with me. He said he motivates us all to be better players and better leaders. And at the end of the day, we have to try and win a few games. So look to him to step up to the plate as long as the rest of the decor as well, guys.
All right, thanks, Carland. Jordan Spence, Kyle Burrows, Brant Clark not playing tonight. They've got to figure out where they're going to be partnered with when the regular season begins. The deflection from big John Parker Jones goes over the net. The 6'7" forward wearing number 83 is out there with Hellenius. And Andre Lee, who's the midget out there at 6'5". Unbelievable. They get bigger and bigger every year. Hellenius again on the left wing boards, tied up. He had an effective game that caught the eye of Jim Hiller in Ontario the other night. Parker Jones sweeps it out, left point. Anderson a shot wide. Spence on the right wing boards, back in deep. Hellenius out to Spence at the blue line, left side to Anderson. To the circle, a shot, blocker save. Decent look there for Anderson. Kings try to get it back to the left shot defenseman, but the Ducks are away with it, and Meyer will send it down the ice. Sidorov in on the forecheck, had it for a moment, but his teammates were changing. And the Ducks will get it through center all the way down into the Anaheim end. Up ice pressure by Fogle. And now Fiala. And a battle in the corner to the right of Oscar Dansk. Fiala works it right point to Burrows. In the middle up high, Gavrikov. A shot steered aside. This line with Byfield, Fogle, and Fiala. They've been together throughout the preseason.
Kings getting a little bit of a chance there to get some forecheck scoring. It started with that young line with all the size. Good use of the body.
Kings have had shot attempts, but a lot of them have been blocked or missed the net here in the first period. Only 5 shots on goal. Anaheim has 6, but early on, first couple of shifts, Anaheim had some real good looks.
And that's kind of opposite, Nick, right to what happened on Saturday. The Kings got in the way a lot, making sure the shots are wider blocked.
Deneau back out with newcomer Tanner Janot. Janot in on the forecheck with a bump on Drew Helleson, who wears number 43. He's bidding to win a spot on the Ducks roster. Puck out to Movarara. His shot through traffic, save, score! Rebound, Tanner Janot! And the Kings are up 1-0.
So the Kings do get one through. It's with a wrist shot, and like so many times, it's not necessarily that first one. Keep in mind, though, this is about the third shift in a row where the Kings have had pressure down low. Janot is known for his toughness, honest, but watch this. He is so good down there. I know earlier in camp he talked about the situation of where he's going to score most of his goals from. In Vegas, he scored on a wrist shot from Kai. Well, he said, that's not where I score my goals. That's where he scores his goals, right there. And you could see him pick up the rebound on his stick and caress it. And without the puck or taking a stick handle, he changed the angle to wrap it around.
I think if you look at it, you go back up high to where the play started with Mo Verar. He did a great job at moving his feet up high. That opened up the lane, allowing him to get the puck to the net for Janot.
Tanner Janot, an acquisition by GM Rob Blake in the offseason, and he'll bring number one physicality, and the Kings hope that he brings some scoring. Had 24 goals as a rookie 3 years ago. So the Kings with a 1-0 lead. The goal at 12:58. Turcotte battling for a loose puck, gets knocked down and gonna get a penalty, and I think they're gonna call Turcotte on this. So a delayed penalty against the Kings as goalie Dansk is to the bench for the extra skater. Strome up the right wing will dump it in, chase it down. Rimmed around the wall now by Lundestrom. Missed everybody and goes down towards the empty net, and the Ducks hustle back. They had plenty of time. Delayed call on the Kings. Newcomer Brian Dumoulin, who had some productive years with Pittsburgh, ahead to Lundestrom. Gains the Kings line in the middle, hands it off to Strome. Strome is tied up, fanned on a pass. Kings still can't get a touch on it to get a whistle. Vetrano on the right wing. Up high for Dumoulin, he's pressured on the play. Fed it down low. Strome across, Vetrano, a chance save is made. Again, Vetrano, cross ice pass. Picked off, touched up, and we will get the penalty call. Kings kill a penalty when we come back, but they've scored first. Tanner Janot.
So Turcotte goes to the box. Ducks with a chance to tie things up. Back to the goal again. Darryl mentioned Mo Verar making a situation where he changes the point of attack. Watch the footwork. Stop here, guys. See the footwork right there? That's allowing him to move laterally with still controlling the puck. And then he gets it through, gets it by. And watch Janot right there. One touch on his own stick. Look at this. One touch, almost a pass to himself around the stick of the goaltender. In behind, slams it home. Kings lead 1-0.
Turcotte goes for a hooking. So the Kings with a 1-0 lead on that Tanner Janot goal go on the penalty kill.
So we got Janot. And then Janot. And I think through the course of the season, Nick, I could probably use those a little bit.
I think you will.
We'll get into that.
I'll bank on it. Lundestrom out there, Vetrano. Olin Zellweger. We mentioned the other night in Ontario. Brant Clark was playing in that game for the Kings Saturday. Zellweger and Clark were 1-2 in the American Hockey League last year among defensemen in points per game. They both averaged almost a point a game. So if you want to know what Zellweger's game is all about, and you've watched Brant Clark the last couple of years progress as a Kings prospect, well, they're cut really from the same cloth.
Yeah, I think Zellweger is not as much of a rover as Brant Clark is, but it's close.
And Zellweger, number 51 at the blue line, sends it down low for the veteran Strome. He'll hand it off and get it back. Power play Anaheim. They work it around and set up the power play. In the middle, Zellweger to Zegras, to Vetrano right side, to Zellweger, to Vetrano right wing. Lost the puck, held in at the blue line, and turned over by Zellweger. Good pressure there by Thomas.
Yeah, Thomas, he understood that it was the nervous point right there. You're right near the blue line. You're afraid of going offside, and that's when you become more aggressive.
Ducks making changes. They're on the power play. They have the man advantage for another 35 seconds. Kings have the 1-0 lead. A board battle, and the Ducks away with it. Work it on the right side. Cedarov taking over. Now they work it up top to Tristan Luneau, who had a look last year. He's a defenseman they're very high on. Tristan Luneau. Spence fans had an opportunity to clear from deep in his own ice. Ducks taking over, and a shot from the right side by Cedarov off a stick and out of play. Hockey is back. Kings fans, head to Crypto.com Arena Thursday, October 24th for opening night against the San Jose Sharks. All fans in attendance will receive a commemorative rally towel. LAKings.com/tickets. Get your tickets today. October 24th.
There you go.
Home opener, San Jose.
How long did it take you to
pack today, Nick, or yesterday?
Two or 3 hours, yeah.
Exactly.
Power play winding down for Anaheim. A loose puck in the air and trying to swat it out of the air was McGinn, but he fanned on it. One shot on goal. Anaheim 0 for 2 on the power play here in the first period. Kings with a 1-0 lead in the slot. Gavrikov shot, hit a skate. Vladislav Gavrikov, his second full season with the Kings. Deadline acquisition.
Like we've seen before, Nick and Darryl from Jim Hiller. On the shift after a penalty kill, you have kind of a mixed up line because Kevin Fiala doesn't see a lot of time on the PK, or at least he hasn't in the past. And he comes out there with Hellenius, and Turcotte stays coming out of the box.
Here come the Ducks. Meyer over the line, a 40-footer wide of the net. Burrows chased down by Meyer along the boards in the corner to the right of Kemper. Puck worked up the wall, deflects in the middle. Gavrikov is on it. Backhands it off the glass, and we'll get it to center ice. 2:28 left opening period. Meyer back again. Back checked on the play. Good stick there. And the Ducks get an opportunity from the left side that again goes off a stick and out of play. That chance from Colangelo, who had a goal for Anaheim on Saturday.
You see the Ducks coming right at you. It looks right here. Yeah, Englund tried to go up the middle. Doesn't get it, but he gets himself out of trouble. Stick on puck. That's what you're looking for right there. You see the skates of Englund go to the inside to make sure the player cannot beat him with a move. A stick outstretched on the puck. Puck into the glass. Over the glass, into the mesh. You get a face-off in your own zone.
Darcy Kemper in goal tonight. The schedule is for him to go the entire 60 minutes, or 65 if need be. Preseason game number 4 of 6. In front it comes, and a chance for Leeson. Got the pass with his back to the net, then flipped it towards the net, but couldn't get it on target. 2 minutes left here in the opening period. Zegras, no-look pass, off a stick into the corner. Kings take over, and they'll get a clear. Flip it down the ice, a foot race out as Dansk plays it past the onrushing Byfield. And the puck at center ice.
Good rotation there in the defensive zone by the Kings. No hesitation by the four players on this side of the ice. Wherever the puck got moved to, they had their green light. They closed, preventing Anaheim from setting up.
Mikey Anderson back out. Will dump it in. A two-time NCAA champ at Minnesota Duluth. He has become a fixture on the Kings' blue line since becoming a regular, what, 5 years ago now. Of course, he's going to start the season with a new partner with the injury to Doughty. Number 44, Mikey Anderson. A feed on the right wing. Thomas on a shoot-in. Akil Thomas got some games in with the Kings late last year. 7 of them. Just under a minute to play. 1-0 Kings lead here in the first period, and the goal by Janot from Moverara and Akil Thomas. Puck between the benches at center ice. Scooped up by Anaheim. Moving in, Colangelo, a centering pass broken up, and the Kings will get a clear. Dumoulin hands it off to his partner tonight, Luno. Luno to the attacking line, turned it over, and the Ducks will reset. Colangelo on right wing. Sends it cross ice into the left wing corner, King's end. Burrows up the wall. He kind of fanned on it. But Lee is there to clean it up. And Lee for the Kings will get it out to center. 10 seconds left in the period. Back comes Meyer, right circle, a chance. Rebound! Knocked towards the net. And a save made. Sidorov had that follow-up opportunity. As the horn ends the opening 20 minutes.
Well, the Ducks had a couple of chances there. Meyer had two good wrist shots there that made it look very difficult. Now, keep in mind the Kings have a 1-0 lead. Tanner Janot with a goal. Having said that, Nick, compared to the last game Saturday, Anaheim, way more puck possession time, way more quality chances. Solid first period by Darcy Kemper.
And a solid first period for Anaheim. They did not allow the Kings a shot since the Janot goal. So the Kings, playing preseason game number 4 here tonight, have a 1-0 lead after 20 minutes at Honda Center. We'll be back. Sean O'Donnell began his NHL career as a King. Played in a lot of cities, including here in Anaheim, and the Kings reacquired him on this date in 2008, primarily to be paired with a rookie defenseman named Drew Doughty. Ooh. Sean O'Donnell still with the Kings organization, working in player development. Nick Nixon along with Jim Fox, Darrell Evans, Carlin Bathe with you as well. Preseason game number 4 for the Kings. And Jim, special teams are always huge. They seem to go in spurts, good and bad stretches throughout the season. But what do you think about the PK so far tonight?
Well, it's something we're going to keep a close eye on because there's been some tweaks to the Kings. They want to have more pressure. Unless the team has 100% total control of the puck, a guy to keep an eye on right here is Jordan Spence, Kings defenseman. The puck's along the wall. Get a stop here. Here's Spence. He's kind of following up the pressure. A lot of times this defenseman would back off into this area right there. Watch Spence. Instead of blocking off, another stop if you can. Look at this. He's after the puck. He's going this way instead of back into that way. So that's that pressure the Kings are looking for. Another stop, you'll see it happen. Stop here. There's two ducks open. But if you don't have enough time to make the pass, well, you can't find the open man. So the Kings will try to be more aggressive. There's many times there'll be guys open, but there's many times the Kings will get there before the passer can find the open man.
Let's head down to ice level and check in with Darrell Evans.
Yeah, I thought that first period, one thing that I wanted to watch through it was the execution and pace. And in the defensive zone down the end where I was at, I thought when the Kings moved with execution in the defensive zone, rotated with the puck, everybody in sync, that allowed them to play with pace, exiting the zone, getting across the center ice red line, going on the attack. I think we'll see more consistency as the season goes on, the more repetitions that they can get in as the games go forward.
Kings lead on the goal by Tanner Jeannot, and that goal came at 12:58 of the first period. That's been the Kings' last shot on goal on goaltender Oscar Dansk. 1-0 LA as we get underway in period two. Ducks get it down the ice. Mikey Anderson lifts it through center to the attacking line where the Kings will work it in deep. Spence defensively with Mikey Anderson. Akil Thomas and Deneau along the wall. Thomas pass out to Spence. To Thomas in the right wing boards. Wristed in down low off Jeannot's stick. Recovers in the left wing boards. Leaves it in the corner for Deneau. Back to Jeannot. But he's checked on the play. And Strome will take over. Get it across and the Ducks to center ice. Lundestrom to the Kings line. Will get it in deep and head off on a change. Kings with Darcy Kuemper in goal for tonight's preseason test. And just for the record, the Kings 2-0-1 in these preseason games so far. All three games have been 3-2 affairs. And through center, Colangelo. Had it knocked off a stick by Gavrikov, recovered in the right side, but his shot went wide, played ahead, and the Kings with some space. Fiala give and go, back in front. Shot, score! Slava Gavrikov, great passing right there, and the Kings have a 2-0 lead.
The pass that was made for the Kings to leave the zone, I believe it was Warren Fogle. I mean, he rifled a pass across the ice all the way up, and then, because of that pass, watch, Fogle has it here, watch this, on the backhand, he gets it right under the stick, so the Ducks had too much of a gap right there. One, two, back, forth, and then finally sliding it between the pads. You see the Kings, but the drive of the net there by Byfield. If Byfield doesn't drive there, it does not open up enough space for Gavrikov. But that first pass, though, a lot had to do with the Ducks not being positioned, taking away the neutral zone, but Fogle, backhand pass right on the stick.
And give Gavrikov his marks because he set up Fiala. And many times with a guy like Fiala, you're going to figure he's going to shoot him tight. But he had the presence of mind to expect that he'd get it back. And he did. And he buried it down low. 2-0 LA. Gavrikov from Fiala. And Fogle. Here's Trevor Zegras in on left wings. Pass broken up. Tried to work it across to the right circle. And the Kings Fogle for Fiala. And off to Byfield. Up the right wing. Charging down low in two deep. He's in behind the Anaheim net. Using his big frame to protect the puck. But his backhand pass is broken up. And the Ducks take over. Zellweger. checked as he got to the attacking line. The Ducks will have to reset, and Hellison will send it in behind the Kings' net. So Tanner Jeannot, a goal in the first period, and now Vladdy Gavrikov here in period two. Fiala and Fogle do get the assist.
Yeah, it's a good example of how, even if you don't have the puck, I think all five guys, well, at least four for the Kings, certainly had something to do there. Even if you weren't going to touch it, you were moving, you were opening. Your line mates followed into the twice on that play. The Kings were able to open up lanes because a guy away from the puck was driving. That opens up the lane once, twice, pucks in the net.
So, if I'm correct, the Kings have scored in their last two shots on goal. Midway through the first and early here in the second.
Keyword is quality.
There you go. 2-0 LA, and in the high slot, shot Gavrikov back out there wide. Burrows a bid through traffic. Save is made. Turcotte battling behind the Anaheim net. Had it knocked off his stick. Picked up by Samuel Fagimo. He'll rim it around the wall. Turcotte for Burrows. Right side, a shot. Block never got through to the goaltender. And now controlled by Studnicka. Kings are changing, but on it. Good read by Burrows. Burrows went all the way across to the left wing. Now Spence on the right side. Spence looking for a lane. Hands it off. Shot from the left circle by Anderson just on his block. And the Ducks will get it down the ice. Mikey Anderson pressured on the play, works it up the wall, and Hellenius plays it ahead to Lee to center to the attacking line. Lee with a quick wrist shot from just inside the Anaheim line, and Dansk was able to turn it aside. And now the Ducks called for icing.
Now Kyle Burrows, we talked about it in the pregame show. We talked about him in our open. And I chatted with him this morning. I asked him about his 5 years in the American Hockey League before he made it to the NHL. He said, there was many sleepless nights where he's, you know, he was up and thinking, and am I doing the right thing? What am I doing wrong? What can I do to get better? All those things. But I think it really did go to form his mentality, his attitude right now, which I mentioned way back, was never take anything for granted.
Kyle Burrows, a right shot defenseman, as we get a hand pass at center ice. Again, Kings and all the NHL teams have to get the roster down to 23 by opening night, which is, what, 10 days away for LA. And Burrows very much in the mix with the injury to Doughty. Kings have 9 defensemen left available to select from. And usually you start the season with 7 defense. And we'll see if that holds true to form.
It's interesting too, Nick, because the Kings are on a long road trip. We talked about that on the East Coast. So the extra guys will be probably more important than normal. But if you're on the West Coast, you really don't have to worry about it. You can call someone up right away.
Yeah, exactly. Ontario, the Kings affiliate, what, 40 miles from downtown in Crypto.com Arena. So yeah, maybe they will start with 8 defense. All depends on the injuries, of course. 2-0 LA. Vakanainen feeds it across. Now tipped to Lundestrom. Back to Vakanainen. Moving down low into the corner. He's in too deep. Banked it off the side of the net. Self-pass, but it winds up to Strome. Strome looking for a play. The veteran, he'll be in his third season in Anaheim. Centers, and a chance from the right side. Kicked out. Just on the ice with that bid was Nikita Nesterenko. And the puck played down by L.A. Deneau back out for the Kings. Philippe Deneau, we mentioned earlier, this will be his 4th year with the Kings. A real consistent performer, averaging just about 51 points a season in his first 3 in L.A. Now he centers, and they score! Akil Thomas, right on cue. Deneau to Thomas, 3-0 L.A.
Yeah, a little bit of this is the Kings were able to make a change and get that line out there. They were fresh. And basically, since the first time they get the puck into the zone, the Ducks were not able to move it. And again, that's credit to the Kings for putting pressure on the puck. Look at that hit right there by the Kings. And that's Jeannot to Deneau. The finish is there. And the Ducks just seem to be a half step behind. You can see right there with Deneau backing off into the corner. By backing off, it spent and gave him more time. Way more time to make that pass. He didn't force it, placed it perfectly.
Two goals and 3:48 here early in the second period, and the Kings have built a 3-0 lead here at Honda Center. So Thomas joins Gavrikov and Janot on the score sheet.
Three goals, three shots.
Yeah, that's right. That's not a good percentage for Oscar Dansk to work with. Playback underway, and a shot handled by Kemper. Bid from the right side by Nestorenko.
Greg Cronin behind the bench again for his second year with the Anaheim Ducks. And I know he's not happy with the score here at all, but it's much better as far as puck possession for the Ducks in tonight's game compared to the last game on Saturday afternoon. Now, that's going to be no consolation when you're down by three. The Kings have been precise tonight. But again, I think on most of all the Kings' goals, everyone was involved. Again, whether you were involved directly with a puck or not. The first goal, a rebound for Janot. Akil Thomas gets a tip. Mouvrard does a good job. Second play, nice pass out of the zone. Driving, open up lanes. Good body contact, good physicality on the third goal. Everyone playing a part.
So the Kings with a 3-0 lead from the corner. A centering pass by Zegras in a skate. Kings content to just lob it down the ice. A foot race after it. Byfield chopping at it with a goalie stick, and it deflects out of play.
Something we'll probably see a little, you know. That time there, Fiala, he had the puck in his own zone, but he said, I'm just going to allow Quinton Byfield to use his speed. And it wasn't quite a lob pass, but it was just lobbing to an open area, open space, and Quinton almost got there.
Byfield, Fogle, Fiala out as the Kings win the draw up high. Fiala a chance and a save by Dansk, who saw it all the way. We'll take a timeout. The Kings have added two more here in the second period. Gavrikov, a defenseman. Thomas, a forward. 3-0, L.A.
And Quinton Byfield sporting the tinted mask this year. He was on the 32 Thoughts podcast, and he talked about permanently making the change, going to the tinted visor. He tried it last year after a game in St. Louis. He wore it in practice. He got chirped by his teammates, maybe a little bit too early in his career. So right now, a little bit of light sensitivity with his eyes. He's wearing it and got it on tonight, and so far his team's playing well.
Yep. Yeah, he'll get used to it as the players have gotten used to the equipment changes over the years and the mandates with helmets and then visors and then tinted visors. Good start to the second period for the Kings. Two goals on four shots, and they have a 3-0 lead here in this preseason game. Kings again will open the regular season on the road. Their first seven to start the season will be on the road. Starts in Buffalo on Thursday, October the 10th.
How about the same start this year on the road?
Yeah, wouldn't that be nice? Yeah, the Kings set an NHL record last year by winning their first 11 road games. Buffalo's going to be tough. Kings have, for some reason, that has been a tough city for the Kings to win in the last 15, 20 years.
To win, to stay within five or six or seven or eight, just be around it.
I think maybe Buffalo has scored the last 14 goals in the two games in that building.
Oh, what's your point, Nick?
Yeah, it was 7-0 last year. Yeah, I don't know if the guys eat buffalo wings when they get there, but maybe they should change their diet. That's not working. On the right side boards, Pezik, veteran defenseman in camp on a tryout, wearing number 3. Bill wristed in down low. Now he's going to pinch into the corner to keep the puck alive. Rimmed around. Meyer is on it. Meyer's pass broken up. Good stick there by a couple of Kings, including Fogimo. And now the Kings will lift it out to center ice.
Jordan Spence right there. He thought he was on the penalty kill. He started the forecheck. He kept going forward.
Yeah, his partner tonight, Mikey Anderson, talked about him earlier today, and he said, Jordan's just got so much more confidence in his game now. And I think with Drew Doughty being out, I think he senses the opportunity is really good. He's worked on all elements of his game. He's a little bit stronger, and again, the confidence has given him that little extra jump that he needs.
Kings have the size out now. Hellenius in on the forecheck. He has been a physical presence in the games he's played here in the preseason. Sammy Hellenius, his dad played in the NHL. 6'6" is Helenius. Hellison at the blue line across to his partner, Zellweger. He'll hand it off, get it back, drive in too deep. Moves behind the Kings' net. Now he threw it in front and a chance in tight. Save is made. Rebound still alive. It was Strom who had that opportunity. Going to get a penalty on the play as the puck is cleared down the ice.
Well, the Kings' net is off the mooring. It's well off the mooring. And now with the Ducks having the puck, they're going to have to blow this down.
Yeah, yeah, I don't know what they're waiting for. Yeah,
there's a faceoff coming back the other way regardless.
And they're not going to be able to score, so it's actually beneficial here for the Ducks to just get it going and get the faceoff going. But
put the stripes on, Foxy.
There you go. Watch this. We'll see how it comes off. With every,
Angel's number 83 has a minor penalty interference.
Comes across. There's a jam to push by Parker Jones and Zellweger. That created the net to come off. So it's not the goaltender. And we'll see. There is the cross check right there. So making sure that the secondary chance is not developing. In doing so, you get a chance to go to the box, and the Ducks get a chance with a man advantage.
And just watching Parker Jones in the rookie tournament a couple of weeks ago, he took three or four cross-checking penalties. A lot has to do with his size, that when he's pushing away, he comes down on guys with his hands apart. He's got to learn to keep his hands together on the stick. That'll negate some of those cross-checking penalties.
He goes for interference, and again, Parker Jones is listed at 6'7". Third power play for Anaheim. Kings have a 3-0 lead. Anaheim one shot on goal in their first two man advantages as Burrows and the Kings get a clear. Zellweger playing a lot with the man advantages, but his outlet pass missed everybody. Goes down, and Darcy Kuemper will hand it off, and Anderson will send it back down. Up ice pressure by Byfield. Forcing an errant pass. Spence sends it right back in. Power play down to 1:08 left. Here's a turnover. Kings get a chance from the left circle, and that's just wide. May have gone off a defenseman's stick. Fogle at the left side, let it go. Now Leeson and the Ducks chasing it down in the King zone. Luno across, shot, Colangelo wide. Set up for the one-timer was San Colangelo. Kings trying to make a play, turn it over, held in Leeson. Now got it to the right circle. Spinning, holding on, Cedar off. Down low to Leeson at the goal line, put it right through the blue paint. Comes off the wall and out the center.
You saw right there Jordan Spence going down, flat on his stomach to take away any potential pass through the crease. Pass actually made its way through, but then he spun around with his stick. So body, stick, whatever it takes to break it up.
Yeah, change of personnel on the penalty kill. You see guys like Byfield, Fogle out there, a lot longer, a lot more aggressive. The opposition looks differently upon you. Both those guys scored 20 goals in the league last year, so you've got to be a little more protective of the puck because those guys are looking to counterattack and come right back at you.
24 seconds left on the man advantage. Ducks have the man advantage. Kings have the lead at 3-0. And off the draw, it's tipped down the ice. Fiala up ice pressure on young Zellweger. And ahead to center to Strome. Strom will wrist it in. Puck winds up in traffic in the right wing corner. Burrows away with it and slaps it off the boards out to the blue line. Held in. Lundestrom fed it in deep, and Gavrikov up with it. He'll play it off the glass and out to center. And Parker Jones out of the penalty box. Another good penalty killing effort by the Kings. Did not allow a shot on goal. Here's Zegras. A chance and a glove save by Kuemper, whose glove hit one of the Ducks off to his left. Perfect on the penalty kill are the Kings. They're perfect on the scoreboard.
Welcome back. Carlin Bathe here. Kings newcomer Tanner Jeannot is looking to find some chemistry with his line mates so far this preseason. Tonight, he's alongside Phil Deneau and Akil Thomas. And guys, I'm going to say he's a man of his word because when I asked him last week what he's attempting to do this preseason, he goes, I can find more space for who's on the ice. I can be physical. I can be hard on the forecheck. I like to be first on the puck. I think he bought some space in that last goal. He's doing what he says he's set up to do.
Carlin, he was able to make the contact, spin his body around, regain possession of the puck all in one motion, and that gives his line mates more time to move it around.
27 years of age is Tanner Jeannot. Came up with Nashville, then went to Tampa, and the Kings acquiring him in the offseason. We've talked about this in the preseason, Jim and Daryl, but Jim Hiller wants the Kings to be a little tougher, yeah, a little bit more aggressive, and, well, that's Jeannot's game to a T, really.
And he also scored exceptionally well at the fitness testing at the beginning of a training camp for the Kings. So you come to a new team, and you want to make sure you're making a great first impression. That's the way to do it.
Off the draw with the Kings leading 3-0. The Ducks will play it down to the Kings line. England being pestered on the play by Nestoranko. Fires it off the left wing boards. Ducks knock it down, keep it in. But Deneau will take over. The veteran center behind his own net. Double teamed off the puck. Nestoranko, while falling, threw it in front. But guarding that post was Kemper. To start the season with the ultimate LA Kings and Mammoth Mountain prize package. One lucky winner will receive four LA Kings season tickets, one two-night stay at Mammoth Mountain Inn, two two-day lift passes, and more. Enter for your chance to win at lakings.com/mammoth.
I was going to say that was a 1-2-2, but I think that was a 1-4-2 on that one.
Yeah. Used to be the 1-3-1 last year.
Exactly.
3-0 LA, 8:04 left, second period. Final two preseason games in Quebec at their brand new arena. Thursday against Boston, Saturday with Florida. The Stanley Cup champs, a chance in tight. Save is made by Kemper. No rebound for Anaheim, and the Kings away with it. To center ice, and Turcotte will lift it in deep. Chased down by Studnicka. Had it knocked off his stick, pinching his Burrows. Burrows collides with Vetrano, and the Ducks to center ice with Leason. Leason by the Anaheim bench at the blue line is bumped off the puck. And they battle for it between the benches, and the Ducks will get it in deep. Good play standing up. The Anaheim forward was Gavrikov. And to center ice, Studnicka for Fagimo. Samuel Fagimo back to Fiala just on. Fiala's pass in the middle, broken up. And here's Nestoranko the other way for Anaheim. No, no. Nestoranko will chip it in. He'll chase it down with Anderson. The two cancel. The Kings play the puck ahead to Fogle. Fogle's pass deflects in the air. He recovers, sends it across to Anderson. And Anderson up the wall and down the ice. On it is Vakanainen being pursued by Byfield. Byfield tying up Vakanainen. Now Fiala trying to come in for the puck, but the Ducks are there and they'll get it to center ice. Jordan Spence will hammer it right back in. 3-0 LA, 6.5 left, second period. Kings getting two in the forecheck, and Spence has the puck now for Fogle behind the net, who threw it in front, and Fiala denied from just outside the blue paint.
Now you just look at the Kings defending in the neutral zone. Gavrikov does an outstanding job. As the Ducks make their way through, they're trying to get across and penetrate, get into the offensive zone. Leason coming across, was forced to move laterally. Gavrikov closed the gap at him, sealed him along the boards, separating him from the puck. That allowed the Kings to come back the other way.
Gavrikov along with Thomas and Jeannot, the goal scorers here tonight for L.A. Kings last season, a playoff team for the third straight season. 99 points, a record of 44, 27, and 11. We mentioned they started last season with 11 straight wins on the road. They wound up winning 22 road games and 22 home games. And the big boys out now, Hellenius, along with Lee and Parker Jones. Lee works at right point, spends a shot, blocked, and deflects out of play.
So that young group at the top. Then you have to use the size effectively. Hellenius did so earlier in the first period with a counter hit. I've been told, I haven't had a chance to watch a lot of his games in Hellenius, but he's really worked well to protect the puck a little bit more. His winger right now is on the right side. Lee has done a good job on the boards and improving there. Of course, Parker Jones, new to everyone here with the Kings.
We had Marco Sturm on during the broadcast Saturday in Ontario. He was talking about some of the young players and a guy like Hellenius. And kill penalties, win faceoffs, use your size. Ooh. You can play in the NHL. You don't have to score goals. But there are roles that players can be slotted into.
Helenius took a run at someone. Now he's the chance.
There you go. Helenius to the net. Centers! But Lee had his stick tied up by Zellweger. Good effort defensively by Olin Zellweger to deny the Kings a good scoring chance. Sidorov will work it in behind the Kings' net. Andreas Englund out there with Moverara defensively. Englund, a physical presence for the Kings on the blue line last year. Ahead to Deneau, weaves his way to the left circle out to the blue line across to Moverara, right point. Moverara will play it in behind the net. Ducks up with it, but they turn it over. Deneau on the right wing boards. Deneau being challenged. Feeds it in the middle up top. Shot Moverara blocked. Never got through to the goaltender Dance. 5 minutes left. Second period, 3-0 LA. Deneau chases it down again. Tried to feed it in front, but Thomas couldn't reach it. Deneau gets it back. Philippe Deneau outside the left circle. Plays it to the blue line across to Englund with a drive. Smothered by Dance. And a whistle. Kings have all the goals here tonight. Up 3-0.
Top tier plays presented by Arco. All Kings so far. First period, change the point of attack. A little deflection by Thomas. Janot, real good hands down low. Look at the drive by Byfield. That allows time. Give, go, back, forth. Puck in the back of the net. Then the forecheck. And Deneau buying himself some time, backing off. Thomas, little thing right there, but he drives the net with a stick on the ice. That gave Deneau a target. Pucks on the stick, pucks in the net.
Mikhail Thomas, 7 games late last season in L.A. Won himself some points by scoring 3 goals and playing a physical brand of hockey. Of course, the key for him, well, it's a key for everybody, every athlete, staying healthy. He had shoulder issues earlier in his career after he was drafted, but when he's been healthy, he's been an effective player. 3-0 LA. Burrows at the right point. Wristed in down low. Leeson up with it. Leeson in the corner. Bumped on the play. Board battle. Studnicka is there. Out there with Fagimo and Turcotte. Kings get it to the blue line. Send it back in down low. Controlled by Fagimo in the slot with a shot. Set up by Turcotte. Save made. And Vetrano will play it back the other way into the Kings end. Zegras behind the net. Now into the left wing corner. They get it up high. Zellweger, left side, a shot wide. Ellison on the right side. Wristed around. I think one of the Kings' Burrows collided with Kemper. Unfortunately, the puck didn't wind up in the goal crease. Ducks putting the pressure on here. Vetrano, Leeson working in the corner. Gavrikov is there with Turcotte for the Kings. All of this in the corner to the left of Darcy Kemper. With 3.5 left in the second period. And the Kings with all 3 goals here tonight. Janot, Gavrikov, and Thomas. Puck worked free. Fed across Zellweger. Shoots. Missed the upper right corner. Good look for Olin Zellweger. Now in the middle up by Colangelo. A shot blocked. Kings looking to get a clear, but Toronto knocked down from behind. They play on and a battle in the corner to the right of Kemper this time. And up with a loose puck looking for a clear and getting it is Burrows. But the Kings won't be able to change.
And the Ducks have had a much better forecheck tonight's game. Now, again, has not turned in any goals. Their best chances came early in the first period. You see Zellweger there changed the point of attack with a nice little pull and drag that allowed the potential shot blocker to skate by the lane. Then he tries to put it on net.
Zellweger, just 21, second round pick in the 2021 draft. Ducks without two youngsters that likely are going to be their top two centers, not only this year, but they hope for years to come. Leo Carlson and Mason McTavish, both former first-round picks, but neither one playing here tonight. Dumoulin off the draw for Colangelo, who's bumped by Burrows along the wall. And now a battle puck out to Dumoulin. Dumoulin walking the line, hands it off. And Harkins will get it in down low. Looks a Bruins have put together a couple of good shifts here, and Kings have five players have been out for a while. Now they get one change. Nesterenko in, feeds it to his right, but the pass to Harkins broken up in the slot. Dumoulin shot, pass tipped over the crossbar. Kings still trying to get control and get wholesale changes. Period winding down. Kings reaching for pucks, can't get a handle on it. Boy, they have got to be gassed, right?
Byfield's the only fresh player out there. He was the player to be able to come on the ice.
Foggy Moe trying to tie up Dumoulin. Dumoulin feeds it across. Harkins pass deflects up high to Dumoulin. Few of the Kings out there have been out there for over 3 minutes. Here's a shot that's blocked. Gavrikov to the bench. Studnicka to the bench. Now Foggy Moe as back comes Strome, but we get a whistle offside Anaheim.
Yeah, the Kings on their heels. There was a couple of times that the Kings had possession, but never really clear enough. And they probably just did not want to ice the puck again. Now, throughout that entire sequence, going back to the last game Saturday afternoon, the Ducks had no shots. So the Kings were dead tired. They were chasing the possession there with the Ducks, but find a way to get a stick on it, find a way to get a body, and deny shots.
Yeah, good effort by the Kings, who were pressed in their own ice as the Ducks went through a couple of line changes. And the icing, racing up the right wing, McGinn, the veteran, centered in front, cleared away by the Kings. McGinn, one of a number of Ducks players that fought off an injury last year. Going to get a penalty here, big hit, a cross check behind the Kings' net.
That seems to be the call of the night. And just when it looked like the Ducks going to have all the pressure, they had all the pressure, but...
Anaheim minor penalty number 16, 2 minutes for cross-checking.
So Ryan Strome goes off with a cross-check in the offensive zone. Again, it doesn't mean as much now because of the preseason, but Strome a little bit frustrated. It's that push and shove, and the area it took place near the boards. And that's going to be called time and time again. So after all that pressure, the Kings dodge a bullet, escape with a power play.
This is their second power play tonight. Kings actually have been outshot. We're outshot on that first period power play, 2-0. That was when Vetrano had that breakaway. 3-0 LA, second period winding down here at Honda Center. Kings win the draw, set up the power play. A shot from the middle by Spence's block. Never got through. Byfield is out there with Deneau. Deneau got the puck to Spence. Plays it across. Fiala to Spence, under a minute to play. Back to Fiala with a shot block. Vakanainen got in the way of it. Back to Fiala at the blue line. Across to Spence. And down low, Deneau hands it off. Fiala at the goal line in front. Studnicka denied. And a whistle as the goalie freezes the puck.
Yeah, just something for the Kings coaching staff to think about with Studnicka there. Watch the move he makes down low. If you're a right-hand shot, you get more chances on the power play. Watch him take it, pull, drag, turn, spin, protects it with his own body. That's a very difficult play to execute. Studnicka does so for the shot. Well, the save is there, but there's something to put in the back of your mind that if he becomes that depth player the Kings expect of him, well, maybe he can be used in that role every once in a while.
Studnicka wearing 53 here in the preseason, out there with Byfield and Deneau, and off the draw, power play winding down, as is the second period. Fiala on the left wing boards for Deneau, and to Spence, moves in the middle, feeds it to Fiala, shot pass blocked. 24 seconds left in the period. Kings recapture, but now a pass out to the blue line, hit a duck, and the puck is carried through center by Deneau, and he'll get it in deep.
Of all the players that are kind of on the bubble, and there's a lot, more than the pass for the Kings, I think Studnicka has been the guy for me, Nick, at least in the last couple games, where he brings some NHL experience. Second period will be over here with the Kings leading 3-0, but he's done the job. He's shown that he can keep up with the pace and do the little things.
So, 40 minutes in the books. The Kings had two more goals in the second period. Gavrikov and Thomas. Jeannot in the first period, and after 40 minutes, the Kings are up 3-0. Coming up in between periods, our gang will talk things over. We'll be back. Getting set for the third period here in Anaheim. 3-0 Kings as the Kings play preseason game number 4 of 6. The next two in Quebec against Boston and Florida. Nick Nixon along with Jim Fox, Darrell Evans, and Carlin Baith as well tonight. Jim, looking at the stats after two periods, and we talked about the big line the Kings have here tonight. Helenius with Lee and Parker Jones. Well, Parker Jones and Helenius are 1-2 in hits, 4 for Parker Jones, 3 for Helenius. So using their size, certainly we've seen that here tonight.
And we have not seen them run out of position. We haven't seen them out of control. We've seen them in a situation where, yes, they've controlled the puck a couple times. They protected the puck a couple times. So very smart with the use of size.
We go down to ice level right now. Check in with Darrell.
And looking at the pace and execution by the Kings, I think it was very evident on the goals they scored in that second period. The pace of that first one coming out, execution, good passes, ends up in the back of the cage. And then on the forecheck, establishing the cycle, quick execution, very deliberate, direct, taking the puck to the net.
I think to a certain extent, Darrell, the Kings just want, you know, I know it's preseason. You go back to the first 5 minutes, there were two good chances, maybe in the first 2 minutes by the Ducks. But since then, four checks, yes, possession, yes, but you see if the Kings can get in that situation where they just continue to play a consistent brand here in the preseason.
Kings start the period. They've got power play time as Fiala tries to send it across to Deneau. Now Spence up high. Kings on their second man advantage here tonight, and their first since early in the game, really. Fiala battling along the boards. They still scrum for it.
Byfield's wide open.
Yeah. If.
Studnicka finally works it out to Spence, to Fiala, to Spence in the middle. Shoots, save, rebound. Score! Trickled in off the goaltender. And it will be a power play goal, I believe. No, maybe not. I think it came 2 seconds after. Byfield on the rebound makes it 4-0.
Byfield was open. We talked about that earlier. If you don't have a chance to make the pass, you don't have time, you can't find the open man. But what Byfield does here, you'll see the movement back to the point. Byfield's out of the screen right now, but he's wide open on the far side in the middle. Watch what happens, though, when Spence gets it. When you want to do on the power plays, get a shot from the middle. And Spence is able to get to the middle. Here's the shot. Studnicka again. And it hits a couple of different things, right? It's pinball action before it ends up in. Byfield ends up propelling it over the line, but nice situation there for the Kings and how the defenseman Spence gets it to the middle. Studnicka again, Nick, you know, just involved in that play by getting to the front of the net.
And Jim, the way that Spence was able to bring that puck off the boards, he's a right-handed shot playing his offside. He had to really finagle that puck nicely.
Darrell, could you tell it almost looked like on the first replay that it hit Dansk in two different places before it went in?
Yeah, it sure did. It looked like it had two stoppages there for a split second, but and then Byfield, you know, just again, good job hanging around the net. That's where you're going to score a lot of those garbage goals.
46 seconds into the period. Kings got a goal early in the second, a minute 22 in. Gavrikov. So 4-0 LA. They have 4 goals on 17 shots here tonight. The two goaltenders apparently will go the distance for their respective teams. Kemper for the Kings, Oscar Dansk for Anaheim. Anaheim will be without their longtime number one goaltender, John Gibson, to start the season. He had an appendectomy last week. Will miss 3 to 6 weeks, which means Lucas Dostal likely will get the bulk of their games until Gibson is ready. Lee over the line on left wing, bowls his way towards the net, but he's sealed off. Loose puck in the right corner, now work back to Lee behind the net. Lee pinned there. In to help out is Parker Jones. Byfield is back out. Byfield out there in place of Hellenius. You really don't lose much size, do you? In that exchange with Quinton going 6'5". 4-0 L.A. Here is Fiala. Now out to the blue line, a shot wide by Mobarara. Puck chased down by Fiala, who's averaged almost a point a game in his two seasons as a King.
And again, the King's able to get Quinton in a situation where he's able to bounce the puck in. Studnicka stick on the ice. Studnicka. Yeah, it hit Dorstalnik. Excuse me. It hit Dansk. Probably on his glove hand or arm. Then it went between his legs, and he actually kicked it in himself. So there was at least two contacts there. But Byfield was the shooter on the play. And he gets the goal for the 4-0 lead.
And Spence, with his good work along the wall, is rewarded. He gets an assist. He might have tipped the Spence shot.
Yeah, yeah.
But before that, he did good work along the wall with his teammates. Studnicka with some pro experience. Now in front, a pass just off the stick of Fiala. And the Ducks will lob it down the ice. Leeson. And a battle with Mobarara. Akil Thomas. Thomas will flip it off the wall and out to center. Frank Petrano had a real good look early in the game, shorthanded. Maybe their best chance of the game. Denied by Kemper. Sharp angle shot. Save is made. Zegras with that bit. Got his own rebound. Sets it up to Vaakanainen, who plays it across. And a shot fired wide from the left side by Brock McGinn. The other way, Deneau into the zone. Deneau pushed off the puck. Regains his balance. Can't get control. And now Lundestrom will take over for Anaheim. Lundestrom up the right wing. Working along the boards. Burrows up with a loose puck. And the other way quickly, the Kings with Fagimo. He'll serve it into the left wing corner. Janot started the scoring for the Kings tonight, battling with Fagimo. And now Hellenius. Hellenius with a bump on Zellweger. Mismatch size-wise there. Janot taken down at the Ducks bench at the blue line, and the puck out to center ice. Gavrikov, he's got a goal tonight. Out there with Burrows, they go for a change as it's steered in by Hellenius. Anaheim to center ice. A flip in by Nestorenko. Kings quickly clear it around and down. Up ice pressure by Lee. Puck comes free. Parker Jones, cross-ice pass. Nobody open on the left wing side. Now carried in by Colangelo of Anaheim. Rims it around the wall for Meyer. Meyer chased out to the blue line by Spence. Good job by Meyer to keep it in. He plays it down low. Puck winds up at the right point. Luno moving in the middle to his backhand. To the left wing boards. Tied up on the play. And Lee, with his size and reach, breaks up the play. And at center, Parker Jones will get it in deep. So the big youngsters doing a good job on that shift. Lee, Parker Jones, a unit here tonight for head coach Jim Hiller. 4-0 LA. Again, the Kings home opener is San Jose, October the 24th. Kings will open on the road. Their first seven will be on the road. Five back east, then they'll play one here in Anaheim, one in Vegas before they host San Jose October 24th. On the right wing boards, Pezik trying to win a job. Check. Here's Fogle the other way. In deep for Byfield to chase. Byfield stopped up and turned, but he lost the puck. Fiala out there as well. But Anaheim to center. Vaakanainen to Meyer. And across it comes, broken up, and that is offside. All Kings here tonight in this preseason test. 4-0 LA.
Kings and the Ducks saluting our military personnel in attendance here tonight. A little bit of trivia, Nick. World Championships take place every spring. Czechia won the gold medal last World Championship. Lukas Dostal was the goaltender of the tournament. He was the gold medal winner. MVP of the tournament. That man right there. For Switzerland, the silver medal team, Kevin Fiala.
Yeah, we mentioned just a few moments ago, since he became a king, he has been a very consistent point producer, almost a point a game. This will be his third season as a king, acquired from Minnesota. And we've talked about this here in the preseason, Jim and Daryl, but Fiala's final 2 months of the regular season last year going into the postseason might have been the best hockey he's played for the Kings.
Yeah, I just love the ability to keep the production going, but being reliable and less risky. He was predictable to his teammates, not necessarily predictable to the other team.
Well, Burrows just went into the boards awkwardly. He kind of limped going back towards the bench. Looked like he was favoring his right leg. He's sitting there talking to the trainers right now. We'll see what happens on his next shift.
Yeah, Kyle Burrows seemingly stays healthy, will be with the Kings on opening night with a Doughty injury being a right shot. So, yeah, you're right, Daryl. Hopefully it's nothing too serious as the puck is deflected down off Fiala's stick. Thomas in on the forecheck. Ducks get a quick clear. Deneau taking over up the right wing into the Anaheim end. Tried to flip it ahead. It winds up behind the net, and the Ducks are away with it. Around the wall it comes. McGinn touch pass to center. Strome to the right circle. A shot. Blocker save is made. Decent look there for Strome. And the puck back at center ice. Fed ahead, driving to the net and knocked down on the play. Is that Meyer? Yeah, I think so. Puck out to Luno. Luno's shot as Kemper has finally got his stick back. It was knocked out of his hands. And Hellenius will take over, get to the red line, and get it in deep. Hellenius, Lee, and Parker Jones. Average size, 6'6", the three of them. Out to Movarara. Left side to England. 40-footer. Save is made. Dance can't find it. It's loose. Thrown in front. Still loose in the crease. As it was centered by Lee, but Dance got a whistle.
Let's get all these big guys in the crease all at the same time. And the Ducks are there, too. Push at the end. Parker Jones, who's been noticeable tonight, wants to be more noticeable here in the third. Daryl Mensen, Kyle Burrows on the last shift. The boards have a lot of give in them. Up high and near the glass, but down low, not necessarily the case. You see the spin out right there. Perhaps the toe cap of his right skate, maybe his left skate. Now, I know Daryl and I have had that happen before where your foot and your toes go right through that steel toe. And believe me, the toenails do not feel good after that.
Well, Quinn Byfield stepping onto the ice now along with his linemates Fogel and Fiala. They've been together since the onset of training camp. He's having an outstanding night in the faceoff circle. Carlin Bager showed me his numbers. 8-1 in the faceoff circle, 89%. That's an area. If he can be consistent in that area, that's really going to help this transition into the middle of the ice.
9-1 now.
Yeah. Of course, you would think come crunch time, once the regular season starts, that Kopitar and Deneau would be ahead of Byfield, but you keep winning at that percentage and you're going to get your opportunities. And we'll see also, Daryl and Jim, if he kills penalties on a regular basis. I'm sure Jim Hiller would love to cut back the ice time in that regard on some of the veterans, especially like Andrei Kopitar, who will be beginning his 19th season.
There's a couple of things you look for in penalty killers. I think the first thing is just reach. Taking away that area around you, and then quickness. And Quentin has both of those things.
Another faceoff win for Byfield.
10-1.
Yeah. Out there with Fiala and Fogel. 4-0 LA. Puck up high. Fiala off for England. England to Fiala. Back out to the blue line. England plays it across to his right. Movarara up, set up a goal earlier tonight. And now he gets it back, banks it off the wall for Fogel, but it's picked up, not cleared by Anaheim. Held in by Movarara. Sends it around the wall. Pezik up the wall and out to center ice. Speaking of the Kings on the penalty kill last year, second best in the NHL. Only Carolina was better. So if you can add a couple of more pieces to an already pretty good penalty killing unit. Of course, over the years we've seen Kopitar and Kempe do that, more with Deneau. So
you're right, Nick, the more you can spread it around, right?
Yeah.
It opens up energy for the guys to go on attack a little bit more when they get back even strength on the power play.
Kings a little loose with a puck in their own end, but they recover. Yes. Fed ahead. Here's Hellenius, left circle, a shot save, rebound covered. And Dansk will cover up as the Ducks push away Sammy Hellenius from their goaltender. Ducks are doing the pushing, the Kings are doing the scoring. 4-0 LA here in Anaheim.
I miss a lot, actually. I always thought this city could have a team, NHL team, and it's just awesome that we can play there. I've played once I was in Montreal, a couple games there as well, so it's just fun to have another team than Montreal, you know, to get there and bring in the fans and just to show that it's a good market. So, yeah, it's obviously a great city. I love going there in the summer and just relax.
Mr. Deneau will not be there to relax this time around, but I'm sure the Kings will have some downtime up there preparing for the season. Two games in Quebec City. Check the Kings website for more information on how to find out how to watch or listen or both in regards to those games up in Quebec City.
Brand new building. I wonder if the old one is still there. Do we know, Jim?
Can we see?
Oui. Shot hit the post. Mikey Anderson.
One thing they hope is there. Shane Shaw. The hot dog.
Hot dog capital, yeah. 4-0 LA, 10 different Kings with a point tonight, so balanced in that regard. Janot and Thomas each with a goal and an assist. Kings will play Boston and Florida in Quebec City as we get a whistle for icing, or maybe are they calling too many men? No icing.
It's an icing call, yeah. So the Kings did have the opportunity to change the point of attack, slide across. Look at those bodies. That's what you want to see, right? When you have that size again, Nick, we just talked about it in the intermission coming into this period. The use of size allowed Mikey Anderson to sneak it through, went off the post, but can you imagine being the goaltender trying to find the puck there? I mean, you can't see anything but big bodies.
Philippe Deneau wins the draw. Gavrikov to Burrows, who's okay after going into the boards earlier in the period, but his pass down low hits something and deflects down into the Kings' end.
Hey, Foxy, imagine Panger being in net with those guys in front of him.
Man. Yeah, Darren Pang played maybe 30, 35 years ago, broke in with Chicago, right? Longtime analyst for a number of teams and networks. Covering hockey, doing a great job in that regard.
Panger himself tells a story about when they played Montreal for the first time.
Right. Larry Robinson. I was just thinking of that.
Larry asked a couple of guys on the Blackhawks, hey, where's the other half of your goaltender?
I think he asked Chelios that, who was with the Blackhawks.
Yeah, he said, Chris. Each other.
Yeah. Oh, gosh. Battle behind the Anaheim net. Squirts free. Deneau on Luno, but now Luno's able to make a play to Brian Dumoulin. Ahead to Colangelo. Had a goal against the Kings in Ontario on Saturday. 3-2 Kings win. Kings are 2-0-1 in the preseason for what it's worth. I guess it doesn't matter when you're playing, and it's always nice to get some wins. Ducks have not had a lot of good looks on Darcy Kuemper, so give the Kings credit. Here's a point shot that's blocked as Colangelo tried to get it through from the right side about 50 feet out.
It's good to see a couple of shifts there. That's when they had their best chances, and they had quality chances. But then since then, it's been like the Kings have done very well all preseason long.
Fiala give and go, couldn't get the return. He was tied up on the play by Hellison. As Ellison stayed with his man.
Would you have there, Reggie?
I was just going to say, good to see Burroughs on the ice moving around. No ill effect from falling into the boards there, so that's a good sign for the Kings.
And I've told the story many times, Darrell, where, you know, you hit your feet into the boards like that, your toes go right through the end, your nail. I remember Pete Demers one time, he said the only way to take the pressure off, you could see the blood building up underneath the nail. He just took a needle, he heated it up, and he burned all the way through the nail.
Yep.
And when that hit the skin, it released the pressure, but man, I had a headache because I jumped so high and hit the ceiling.
That's a big jump.
That's a big one for me.
Pete Demers, longtime Kings trainer. Still attends quite a few games throughout the season.
He's not fishing.
Yeah, exactly. Byfield over the line on left wing, again playing center here in the preseason with his wingers, Fiala, who has it now, and Fogel, who's battling behind the net. Now it's Turcotte instead of Fogel, and we get a whistle. Going to get a penalty here, called out by the referee at center ice. It's going to be a roughing call, and it looks like it will be against Fiala.
So, Kevin Fiala.
Los Angeles number 22 has a minor for roughing.
Keeps up the intensity, so to speak, but we know from the regular season he's kind of a marked man for the officials, especially when they're looking away from plays, away from the puck. He got whacked a couple times there on the hands, and there's the punch in the back of the head, yeah. So the retaliation gets called. That check is not bad. I think it was before that, a little frustration, because there was a couple of whacks, I think, into his hands by McGinn. That was not picked up, but certainly the punch was. It was right to the back of the head.
Vex on the power play for the fourth time. Got a chance from the right side, Vetrano. It was blocked and deflected on net.
Broken stick for Jeannot, so down a man and a broken stick.
Zellweger to Vetrano. One times it wide, and he misses the far post. Puck off the wall, and it boomerangs out to center ice.
Now that is just, you can't allow that if you're the Ducks. You can't make that happen. The other team is shorthanded. They have a forward out there with a broken stick, and you shoot wide, and the puck comes all the way out of the zone.
Ducks only one shot on goal on their previous power plays. And here's Lundestrom gaining the line, hands it off to Strom. Strom will play a lot in their power plays this year, the veteran forward, but the Kings, with the good aggressiveness at the blue line by Akil Thomas, break it up. The Ducks come back in the zone onside, but again, Thomas, aggressive, forces the turnover and gets it down.
In the general concept for the Kings penalty kill, unless the opposition has complete, total, 100% control, you have the green light to put the pressure on.
Colangelo moving down low, rims it around the wall. The Ducks made a change, and late getting into the zone was Tristan Luno, so the Ducks have to touch up. Power play time down to 35 seconds. Trevor Zegras will get it into the right wing corner. Down low is Spence. Spence clears it around, and here's Fogel. He'll kill some penalties this year for the Kings. Warren Fogel dragging it at center, and then we'll get it in deep. Fogel killing penalties the last three seasons for the Oilers, and before that he did the job for the Carolina Hurricanes. Warren Fogel signed as a free agent. Power play winding down as the Ducks go offside with 3 seconds left on the man advantage.
Again, Tanner Jeannot out there just trying to get something, piece of it. Stretched out like a goaltender. There's the snap of the stick. Now he's on the other side of the ice. And here's what I was talking about. There it is. It misses. That shot, that's kind of a game management situation there for the Ducks, where you've got to put the puck on net or short side. You cannot allow a clear when the other team is on their heels like that.
One shot on goal for Anaheim as the power play is over. Fiala out of the box. Still 4-0 LA. As a bouncing puck is cleared away from the front of the Kings net by England. Scooped up by Moverara and to Fiala. Fiala tied up. Moverara there. He gets upended, but got it ahead to center ice. Lines up inside the Anaheim line. Pezik will clear it around the wall. Held in England. Throws it in deep. Puck side of the net to Fiala. To his knees. Getting back up behind the net is Fiala. Hands it off. Jeannot out to Moverara. Good reach to keep it in. Moverara back in deep behind the net. Out of the reach of Fiala, but pinching is England. England for Fiala, drives the middle, high slot, hands it off. Janot, a shot, missed the right side, not by much. Good shift here, Hellenius out now. Overskates the puck, gets chased down by the Kings. And reaching for it, Janot couldn't control, and the Ducks do get a clear. Under four to play in this preseason test here at Honda Center, and the Kings have been in control throughout. First period goal by Janot. Two in the second, Gavrikov and Thomas. And Byfield here early in the third. Anderson, a chance from the blue line, kicked out. As Luno between the benches will dump it in off the glass.
A couple of good passes by Jordan Spence as a left shooting lane open for Mikey Anderson. No hesitation. He's got his last two through. That one was kicked out. The other one hit the pike.
Offside LA with 3:06 left to play. Can the Kings hold on for the shutout win? We'll find out when we come back. One of the newest Kings for a second stint in Los Angeles. Darcy Kemp, there's the big save early. Who knows? That could have changed everything. 1-0 Ducks. That was close right there on the same shift. Breakaway could have been 2-0. But then the Kings settled things down. 6'5", 215. He's 34 years old. Saskatoon, Saskatchewan. Then won the Stanley Cup with the Colorado Avalanche. And he was the starting goaltender there. Of course, a lot of puck possession, so he didn't see a lot. But that doesn't... The experience that it takes to go all the way and play through the pressure.
Yep.
178 career wins for Darcy Kemper. He was with the Kings in the 17-18 season and had a 10-1-3 record as a backup to, of course, number 32. Over the years, the Kings have had some real good seasons from their so-called number two goaltenders. Look at David Rittich last year. His numbers were outstanding. And we'll see how it turns out this year with Kemper expected to get the bulk of the duty and Rittich as the number two. Good to see Phoenix Copley in camp. Jim and Daryl had the major knee surgery in January, and he's battling back into playing shape. Good play by Gavrikov to deny a shot by Harkins. Now the puck in front and just shot wide from between the circles. And the Kings will get a clear, and this will be icing.
Yeah, with Phoenix, he comes back in. ACL, very difficult for any athlete, but there's David behind the bench tonight for the Kings. But with Phoenix, Nick, we've mentioned it before, but man, he's, again, another guy who comes to camp and just totally thrashed the fitness test. I mean, it wasn't even close. He's just one of those guys that is so well put together and comes prepared.
Yep. Up high, shot taken, save made. Zellweger got it through traffic. And Fogel out of the King zone. Crossed to Byfield. Byfield stick handling, lost control. Looked like he wanted to knife through a couple of defenders. A minute 30 left. Pass broken up. Nestorenko tried to pass inside the Kings line. Now the Ducks get it back, throw it in front. And a save is made and tied off Nestorenko. With 1:17 left.
Well, a young player wants to make sure he's going to play right to the bell. Nestorenko gets it to the corner, to the middle, jams. One body down, one goaltender down. The Ducks did have a chance right off a faceoff earlier on that shift, too. Harkins wants something. Byfield says no. I mentioned one King down. There it is with Burrows. And the goaltender has to go down to make the save. Gavrikov, ooh, you see the skate go right by him there. Very close on the ice. I mentioned Gavrikov on the chance the Ducks had earlier. You know, just veteran presence. The shot was taken. The rebound was there. Everyone's hacking and whacking. He's just protecting the puck. Not clearing it, just making sure the other team can't get there. Control the stick, watch him get it. Look at this. Yeah, stick on stick. Just those little things that you learn. You learn that early in your career, but then I think you learn how important it is as you get more experience and you really prioritize that stick on stick.
Of course, Gavrikov last year, his partner for most, if not all of the season, was Matt Roy. So that's another decision the Kings have to make going into the regular season, who Gavrikov will be paired up with.
Yeah, it's part of that transition, that word we were talking about earlier. So many differences this year with the Kings team.
Pezik through traffic, a chance kicked out. Big rebound comes all the way down the ice into the Anaheim end. So with 47 seconds left, a loose puck at center is gathered in by Deneau. Gave it on the right side to Tanner Jeannot. And out to the blue line where a shot is kicked out off the stick of Jordan Spence. And recovering in the neutral zone of the Kings. 28 seconds left. Two preseason games left for LA. Both in Quebec. Thursday and Saturday later this week. Against Boston and Florida. Kings open the regular season on the road in Buffalo a week from Thursday. Home opener October 24th with San Jose. Chance in tight. Kicked out by Kemper. 5 seconds left. Up high. A pass broken up by Parker Jones. And there's the buzzer. And Darcy Kemper and the Kings shut out Anaheim here at Honda Center in this preseason test. The final 4-0.
Nick, I'm going to go back to our opening comment before we came on the air just before the game, and it was kind of so far so good, right? And that's the way it has been for the Kings. Again, the start, the first 2 minutes, a couple of chances for the Ducks, but then the Kings settled things down, and it was nice to see tonight. I mentioned a couple times, even if you weren't directly involved in the play, you were an asset to the Kings team. Everyone pulled together.
And I think the Kings, they played with pace tonight. Both for offensively and defensively, they came back, recovered in the defensive zone, and they moved up the ice in units of five. And that, I think, allowed them to have the success they did.
Four different goal scorers for the Kings, who win it by a score of 4-0.